and say thank you to the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Excuse me, technical. I don't need the keyboard here. I don't need the instruments here. Just vocals here. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. If I had 1,000 tongues to sing my great Redeemer's praise, the glories of my Lord and King, the triumphs of His grace. If you know that song in English, you can sing it in English. If you know it in Yoruba, you can sing it in Yoruba. So whatever version you prefer, let's go. Comes something you do instinctively. Amen. You just move the motions, work the motions. Whether it's manual, whether it's auto, it makes no difference because you are used to it. But let's not do it by rote. Let's not do it mechanically. Let's do it practically this morning. And so this message is to draw our hearts to practical thanksgiving. Like we know, thanksgiving means to show appreciation or to demonstrate gratitude, to show gratitude for something that has been done to you. And for little things, we must learn to be grateful. And for big things, we must learn to be thankful. For everything, we must learn to be thankful. And we are to give thanks and to express gratitude for everything at all times in every situation. Why? Because in every situation, there's always room for thanksgiving. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 18 says, in everything, give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. In everything, give thanks. In everything, give thanks. So in every situation you find yourself, you can give thanks to God. You are waiting for a manifestation, give thanks. You don't like where you are, you desire a better place, give thanks for where you are, because where you are is somebody's dream. Amen. Praise the Lord. So in every situation, we must give thanks. Thanksgiving is the oxygen of the kingdom of God. It's the oxygen of your faith. When there is no oxygen, human life can't survive. Hallelujah. So your faith can't thrive without thanksgiving. Your faith, my faith, needs thanksgiving to be energized, to be oxygenated. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Don't forget that we've been told that thanksgiving can't be overdone. We can't overdo thanksgiving. You cannot overdo thanksgiving. You can't do enough of it. Hallelujah. Don't forget that we've been told that you can be extravagant with your thanksgiving. You see, extravagance ordinarily may not be good in certain things, but not with thanksgiving. If I have on two wristwatches like I had on Friday, that could be called extravagance. So I had on two wristwatches, and a gentleman said to me, Pastor, you have two wristwatches. I said, I know, but it's because I'm doing a chronological analysis. I said, meaning there's a reason for it. But ordinarily, if I wear two wristwatches, somebody should wonder what's going on. If I should put on three wristwatches, they should call my wife aside. If I should put on four wristwatches, they should call my uncle. If I should put on five, they should look for my mom's number and call my mother and say, we know you are old, but you must hear this. I got to believe. Praise the Lord. But not with thanksgiving. You can't overdo thanksgiving. You can be extravagant in giving thanks. Hallelujah. You can be extravagant with your praises. You can be extravagant with your worship. You can be extravagant with your adoration, your veneration of the goodness of the Lord over your life. Amen. And it must be done. It must be practical. We've been told that thanksgiving is not an emotion. An emotion is a feeling. I feel like thanking God. Thanksgiving is not an emotion. Thanksgiving is a compulsion. Thanksgiving is a decision. You decide within you to give thanks. There may be no. You think will not fall me down? Hallelujah. How many people understand that kind of grammar? It won't fall me down. Amen. It's Nigerian grammar. Off the generator. Off the television. That's Nigerian grammar. Off the lights. Amen. So my brother will not fall me down. That's wrong grammar. And I'm seeing somebody was writing an official email. I mean, we're gonna. Official mail. I said, can you see? So if whenever we have opportunity to help ourselves with grammar, let's do so, because a generation is missing it completely. Amen. So I'd rather not trip with my agbada, because it wanted to trip me. And I'd rather not trip. I think that's a better way of putting it grammatically. Amen. So thanksgiving is not an emotion. It's not a feeling. It's not something you wake up and then you say, I feel like thanking God. It's a decision that you must execute at all times. way or not. But if you look at Psalm 136 verse 1, if you look at the last verse of Psalm 136 that we just read so beautifully this morning, it says, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord." He's not appealing to your emotions. He's not appealing to your circumstances. He's being unmindful of whatever it is you are going through. He simply declares, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord for his good, and his mercies endure forever." And he ends on that note, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord." Oh, give thanks. There is a presumption in that that you have no choice than to give thanks, because the life in our nostrils can cease any moment. And as long as we realize that we are borrowers of the air in our nostrils, I hope you understand that you are a tenant of times and seasons. Can I say that again? So that the import can sink in. We are tenants of times and seasons. Meaning there is a landlord somewhere of times and seasons. Does the house belong to the tenant? Who has the title to the house? So this house does not belong to the tenant that occupies it. It belongs to the owner, the landlord of the house. So when this tenant inhales and exhales, he's doing that based on the magnanimity of the landlord. And if the landlord will be that generous, that magnanimous to the tenant, then the tenant shall realize that it is mercy and grace that he or she is enjoying. And that calls for what? Perpetual thanksgiving. Hallelujah. So thanksgiving is not an emotion, it's a decision. It's not something you negotiate, it's a commandment. Thanksgiving is thanksgiving. Don't forget that. So let's talk about the practical tips, because we said this is titled Practical Thanksgiving. Number one about thanksgiving is this: you must think about it. You must think about it. For it to be practical, you must think about it. When you think about something, you are mindful about that thing. You are mindful. Your mind is full of it. Let your mind be full of thanksgiving. Be mindful. You're mindful of it. You think about it, you are thoughtful of it. So your thoughts are full of thanksgiving. Hallelujah. You must be thoughtful about thanksgiving. When you are thinking about it, you are reflecting on it. When you reflect, you cast your thinking back to the past. That's what it means to reflect. You go back in your thinking. Amen. And you begin to recall events one after the other, to the best of your ability. I will never forget a phrase that we learned in corporate law class many years back, about 30 years ago to be precise. In that phrase, we're talking about corporate agreements, amen, contracts, offer and acceptance, love, and as it relates to companies. And then in that caption, in that phrase, it says, "Put the agreement in writing because of the relative fickleness of human memory." What caught my fancy there was fickleness of human memory. Human memory is highly fickle. Very, very fickle. What happened 10 minutes ago, you have forgotten. 10 minutes ago, you could have been stretched cold, stretched out cold in a mug somewhere. 10 minutes after, you've forgotten what just happened. We see that all the time on our highways. You're traveling, you get to the scene of an accident, and you see legs this way, you see arms this way, you see heads this way, you see blood all over the place, and everybody slows down. Everybody slows down. And everybody's shaking their heads. So some people trembling because of the shock. And when the traffic moves, you see us, wonderful Nigerians. The speedometer needle hits 120 kilometers per hour, 130, 140 kilometers per hour. On these our roads, the guy just presses down. as far as this is concerned, those ones were not good. They didn't understand how to drive. They don't know how to drive. They had no understanding of Nigerian roads. My brake is brand new. I just changed my brakes. My tires are brand new. I bought them from Pirelli. I just did the balancing and alignment in Pirelli. I did electronic balancing and alignment. So there's nothing wrong with this car. Oh, understand. At 180 kilometers per hour, if I look for my brakes, I find them one time. I can decelerate to 20 kilometers per hour within the space of 30 seconds. I see that every time. We tend to forget so quickly. The fickleness of human memory. Okada riders, they will see an Okada man that just died in an Okada accident. And the next minute, one of them just enters and does James Bond right in front of you. I say, are these people mad? Can they see? Believe me, if I, Tunde Alope, were to be in a position to do something, to change, to exchange your Okada for a car, I would say, Okada, bring your car, bring your Okadas, come and take cars. If I were to be in that position, I would do it. I said, bring your Okada. As long as you can establish title, it's your own. Bring your Okada, come and take car. Don't ride this Okada again. If I were to be in a position. Or don't you feel like that at times? Okay. Back to my message. Think about it. You must think about Thanksgiving. You must be mindful about it. You must be thoughtful about it. You must be reflective about it. You must deliberately cast your mind back to where you were and to where you are right now. Amen. It is something you must do practically. Unfortunately, I can't do it for you. Unfortunately, you can't do it for me. You are the only one to do it for yourself. I am the only one to do it for myself. Hallelujah. That is how we can recognize our milestones. That is how we can celebrate our milestones. Amen. Many times we're consumed, you know, with our unmet expectations, our unfulfilled dreams, and you are locked down emotionally because of those things. We choose to forget what God has done. Again, where you are is somebody's dream. Did you hear what I said? Where you are is somebody's dream. What you have that you are despising is what somebody is praying and fasting for. Praise God forevermore. You see, these children are too many. The school fees are paying is too much. I beg my meaning. The children will cry. This one will cry. That one will cry. You say, wait. But somebody's crying. And crying, say, God, give me just one. You have four. You are saying there are too many. Somebody's crying for one. Unthankfulness. Praise God. Am I the one that said you should have a number you cannot control? What were you looking at when you were, you and your husband were, I don't know. Praise God. Psalm 103 from verse 1. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Verse 2. Next thing. And what? Forget not his benefits. Don't forget. When you think about it, you won't forget. Don't forget. In fact, we have a saying. What is that saying? A piece of paper never forgets. A piece of paper never forgets. A piece of paper never forgets. There's another saying we have. Writing maketh an exact man. When you write it down, you can't forget it. Because over time, 10 years after, when you're going through your stuff again, thank you, Father. Do you understand what I'm talking about? And we're talking about practical Thanksgiving. So think about it. Be reflective over it. Be thoughtful of it. What did God tell the children of Israel? Let's open our Bibles to Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse 10. God, knowing the human nature, gave them a warning. That is the children of Israel, Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse 10. And when the Lord your God brings you into the land that he swore to your fathers, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob to give you, with great and good cities that you did not build. Oh, look at that. God's pattern for blessing his children has not changed up till now. He will give you lands that you did not buy, cities you did not build, houses you did not build with your money. Otherwise, grace has lost relevance. Some people say, I don't want what I don't deserve. Oh. God must always give us what we don't deserve so that grace can be grace. Can I say it again? If you are coming from the standpoint of works and you are saying it is the work of my hands that will feed me, it is good. But beyond the works of my own hands, grace will carry me. What I don't deserve, grace will bring my way, because that is what grace does. So I'm not a product of my works, I'm a product of grace. That's the difference. You keep working and keep planning. 30 days make one pay. This 25,000, let's give back. Nothing left to everybody, nothing left to it's finished. And that is why some will not pay tithes, because they will say, it's not enough. How much are they paying us? How much am I collecting? Something that is not enough, you now say I should bring tithe out of it. Even God can see that it's not enough. You are not making room for grace. And God will say, sweetheart, just go ahead. Spend it the way you want to spend it. I love you. Because he can't hate you. God is love. And then it will be one cycle of disappointment after cycle of disappointment. One experience of disappointment after the other experience of disappointment. And you keep wondering, why are things this way? And you see a pattern. Each time it is almost getting to your turn. They say the thing is no more. They say it's finished. They say we are changing policy. Why must it be when I'm next they change policy? Because you're trying to live by works. You're not trying to live by grace. Let me go back to my message. Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse 10. So when you get to that land that I'm taking you to, a land that I swore to your fathers, to Abraham, to Isaac, to Jacob, to give you, with great and good cities that you did not build, and houses full of good things that you did not fill. Take note of those things. And cisterns that you did not dig, and vineyards and olive trees that you did not plant. Excuse me, did God do all this for Israel? When they got to Jericho, did they build Jericho? Did the children of Israel build Jericho? Maybe you know when they crossed the Jordan. When they crossed the Jordan, where did they enter next? Jericho. They camped in a region initially in the days of Joshua. Remember? And then the Lord ministered to Joshua, told him what to do for the walls of Jericho to come down. Is it in your Bible or not? And when he followed the instruction, where did they enter? Jericho. Was Jericho a city that was being developed, or was it a developed city? Was Jericho a civilization that was evolving, or was it an established civilization? Did Jericho have a culture in progress, or was it an existing culture? Did they have farmlands, vineyards, houses, swimming pools, penthouses, and so on? Did they already have, or were they just building them? Don't you know some people moved into those houses, those vineyards, those farmlands, those swimming pools? Don't you know some people moved into them? Eh? The only person that retained their property was Rahab the harlot and her household. Every other person lost everything that was theirs because there was an exchange. There will be an exchange that will favor you. I said there will always be an exchange in your favor. The position of queen was established in Persia. Vashti's position was an established position. That kingdom was an established kingdom. That kingdom was the ruling world power as at that point in time. A kingdom that spanned 127 provinces of the world. From Persia to India of old. Amen. And overnight, a king was deposed. Overnight, a queen was deposed. another queen took her place. Do you think she began to learn how to be a queen? She did not. She simply stepped into the shoes that Vashti removed. You understand? Whatever honor was accorded the office of the queen, she stepped into it. May God do exchanges that will favor you. Do you understand? We read in the news recently an interview that they did for former President Babangida, and the interviewer said, well, people said that the immediate past president was incompetent. What do you have to say? He said, no, he wasn't incompetent. He was inexperienced. So people read that story recently. He said he was inexperienced. I've been saying at incompetence, at inexperience, please. But as incompetent as you might think he was, as inexperienced as you might think he was president for a period of not less than 5 years. He had access to things you and I have never had access to. In fact, he visited places that some of us will not visit till we die. You understand? I don't have a dream to visit American president. What for? But he went there how many times? Amen. I don't have a dream or a personal desire to address United Nations General Assembly, where every head of state of every nation on earth must speak when they're having General Assembly. As battered as his grammatical expression was, that grammar took him to United Nations General Assembly. And he spoke, and world leaders had to put devices in their ear to understand what he was saying. You don't understand? Somebody say grace. Grace. Having grace is one thing. Using it well is another thing. You know, you can misuse grace. May you not misuse grace. May I not misuse grace. Okay, let's go on. Deuteronomy chapter 6. I will read you in Jesus' name. Verse 10 to 12. No more explanations. And when the Lord your God brings you into the land that he swore to your fathers, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob to give you, with great and good cities that you did not build, great and good cities that you did not build, and houses full of all good things, not empty houses, full of all good things that you did not fill, and cisterns that you did not, and vineyards and olive trees that you did not plant. And when you eat and are full, he did not say if, he kept saying when, because it will happen. And it did happen for them. Then take care lest you forget the Lord, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of a house of slavery. God said, take care lest you forget. By the time you enter that place and everything is roshomo. Amen. By the time you get there and everything is going so good. And they say, Brother, how you doing? You say, I feel good. Says, be careful lest you forget the Lord your God who took you there. Thanksgiving is saying, always remember, never you forget. The battles you fought this year that you won, the battles God fought on your behalf this year that you made you, never you ever forget them. Never you ever forget them. Never you forget them. Some of you fought battles in your dreams and you won. And then you saw the physical manifestation. Never you ever forget that. Never you ever forget that. That is the finger of God. There was a king in the Bible. There is a king in the Bible. God visited him. God was merciful to him. God was gracious to him. He was sick. He called upon the Lord. The Lord healed him. The Lord healed him instantly. I mean, there was a word, King Hezekiah. And the Lord sent prophet Isaiah, said, put figs to the boil. It is believed in some theological circles that he was afflicted with cancer. It was cancer of the skin that he was afflicted with. And so those sores broke out all over his skin. That man was going to die. They medical knowledge in their day, maybe if they had done a biopsy, they would have seen that the string of those cells, those cancerous cells, were the ones that will, in 3 months, the man must be dead. Some in weeks, matter of weeks, they eat up everything and the person is no more. I said, just like that. The devil is bad. You know, all the cells have different levels of mutation and so on. Okay. But Hezekiah was healed. Let's read 2 Chronicles 32. 2 Chronicles 32 and verse 24. Hezekiah was healed. And in those days, Hezekiah was sick to the death and prayed unto the Lord, and he spake unto him, and he gave him a sign. The Lord gave him a sign, because he asked the Lord for a sign. He said, how will I know that this word that you have spoken, Isaiah, will come to pass? He said, what do you want God to do? He said, let the sun down, go back 15 degrees on the steps or the staircase of Ahaz. You know that I've always said this, every dispensation has its own civilization. Every dispensation has its own technology. So they didn't have clocks like we have now, but they had something called a sundial to know what time of the day it was. Amen. So he said, to put it in our contemporary language, let the hands of the clock go back 15 degrees so that I can be sure that what you have said will come to pass. We're not reading that now, but it happened exactly the way Hezekiah said. Verse 25, but Hezekiah rendered not again according to the benefit done unto him. In other words, Hezekiah was not grateful to the Lord for healing him and recovering him of his illness. Why? His heart was lifted up. When your heart is lifted up, what does that mean? Pride. There's pride. Ingratitude is a manifestation of pride. Let's not be proud. Let's learn to be grateful. Let's learn to be thankful. Praise the Lord. Therefore, there was wrath upon him and upon Judah and Jerusalem. There was wrath upon him. If there was wrath upon him, was his wife spared? You're not sure. If there was wrath upon him, were his children spared? Was his kingdom spared? Everything he had was affected. Thanksgiving has a way of affecting everything we stand for. When you are giving thanks, generations from you are being blessed. You are preparing ground for them. So thanksgiving is highly spiritual. Amen. So I said, think about it. In thinking about it, consider likely occurrences if God did not intervene divinely. When you are thinking about why you must be practical with thanksgiving, you must also figure out what God spared you from. If God did not arise, my daughter had surgery this year. She had an appendectomy this year. They put her under local anesthesia. She's such a strong lady. That didn't get the job done. I don't know how many doses they administered. So they had to put her to sleep under general anesthesia. Even under general anesthesia, she told me, said, everything they were saying I had. Under GA, she said, everything they were saying I had. Said the surgeon said, she has the body of a 33-year-old woman. And this is a 15-year-old girl. I don't know what our mommy in our house has been giving all of us to eat. I think you should have said, then stop eating. She gives us everything to eat and she doesn't eat. She starves so that she can maintain her figure. Some people, some Christians must learn to be generous to themselves and not only to others. When you are cooking, you eat. What you cook, you give to others. Back to my message. I'm not looking at anybody. You must not be cooking. They will cook the tea and then they serve themselves. It's a very small portion. You say, even a toddler cannot eat this. They say, it's okay. Eat them. Eat. It's good for you. Praise the Lord. But many people have died under general anesthesia. Many that did not wait. Maybe there was a complication along the line. Maybe things got into the lungs and so on and so on. And they did not come back to life. Or you've not heard of such cases before. They even say in medicine, never say never. Meaning anything can happen. Praise the Lord. not talking of surgical procedures generally, but it's like a maxim. You never say never. And that's about life too. You never say never about life. Praise the Lord. So when you think very well, you will even figure out likely occurrences, if not for the fact that God intervened. If not for the fact that God had mercy upon you, you would have rammed it into that vehicle facing you. You would have had that head-on collision this year, and only God knows where you would have landed. Amen. I can't count the number of times God spared me from terrible road accidents. Amen. It's the goodness of the Lord. Also, when you are thinking about why you must be thankful, always consider the less fortunate. Look at the less fortunate around you and see what God has done for you and be grateful. When you realize that, you say, I only have one pair of shoes on. But what about the man who has a stump where a foot should have been? Let's consider those who are less fortunate. Say, this is my eyes, eh? The eyelash. Is it eyelash? You call it women. It's too long. I want to. Some people don't even have a tongue. You are changing the color of your hair because your hair is very long. There are some ladies, they don't have hair. They've done everything. They bought hair grower, hair protein, hair carbohydrate, nothing. But thank God I'm a man. Women have wala. Cha-cha-cha. I will never forget one year there was serious hamatan. And you know, most men, we don't put cream on our bodies, most men. That day I sat at my wife's dressing table. I was looking for cream. I said, this hamatan, every part of my body was white. Finally, I saw one. I applied it. I rubbed it on my body. Everywhere was shiny. I said, hey, this is better. I never asked her. I said, where did you buy that's your cream? She said, which one? I said, that one. She said, pink oil. Yes. I said, hey. But the way you are laughing, wait. Let me see the number of men who are laughing. Some men are laughing. Do you know pink oil? Yeah, I didn't know pink oil. She says pink oil. She says for the hair. I said, hair care. I said, I put it on my body and it. Can you imagine? Why must they call it pink oil if it is for the hair? Why not say hair oil or something? Say you wonder. Praise the Lord. But gentlemen, it's good for hamatan. It will work for you. I recommend it. So think about it, number one. Point number two, be prompt with it. Practical things, be prompt with it. Don't delay when it comes to expressing your gratitude for what the Lord has done. Don't delay. Be prompt with it. Do not delay to thank God. Learn to be immediate with your praise. Be immediate with your praise. Just say, at family altar tonight. Remind me, at family altar tonight. You are telling your children, remind me, at family altar tonight, we thank God. Be spontaneous with it. Do it there and then. And again, you can do it at family altar. Is that okay? Be immediate with it. Be prompt with it. When the Red Sea divided, when Moses crossed the Red Sea with the children of Israel, thanksgiving that came was what? Spontaneous. Was spontaneous. Exodus chapter 15. Let's read from verse 1. Exodus 15 from verse 1. The song of Moses. Then Moses and the people of Israel sang this song to the Lord, saying, I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider, he has thrown into the sea. We sing that song today. The Lord is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. This is my God, and I will praise him. My father's God, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name. Pharaoh's chariots and his host he cast into the sea, and his chosen officers were sunk in the Red Sea. Do you know, as Moses sang that song, do you know the next person that took it again from him spontaneously was who? Miriam. She took it spontaneously. And then, you know, women, they have a way of putting female swagger into things. They put a dance on it. They got tambourines. Other women joined her. Oh yeah. Sing unto the Lord, for he has triumphed. It was spontaneous. They were prompt with it. See verse 20. And Miriam the prophetess, the sister of Aaron, took a timbrel in her hand. That's like a tambourine. I hear some people call it jamboree. You know, I won't mention the name of that church. People there call it jamboree. And Miriam the prophetess, the sister of Aaron, took a timbrel in her hand. And all the women went out with her with timbrels. Listen, did they plan it before? It was spontaneous. They were prompt with it. They mediate with it. Call a family meeting to thank God. That's the message. Tomorrow we are thanking God. Everybody take note. I want you all. Anybody, it's good to be head of family. Amen. I want everybody to report in Ibadan tomorrow. We are thanking God. And Miriam answered them, sing ye to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider he has thrown into the sea. Be prompt with it. In fact, it's a spiritual principle. Be prompt in responding to whatever God tells you to do. Be prompt in responding. Amen. Look at the woman at the well of Sychar. Jesus met her. They had a conversation. The next thing, she ran into the city. She told the man, come see a man who told me everything that I ever did. Is this not the Messiah? She was prompt with it. Hallelujah. Some will hear and they won't talk to anybody about it. They will keep thinking and internalizing it, you know, just themselves alone. But she became an evangelist instantaneously. Hallelujah. Come see a man. She was prompt with it. Be prompt with the dealings of the Spirit of the Lord. When the Spirit of the Lord says, do this, do it then. Don't rationalize. Amen. Logic and faith don't go together. Did you hear what I said? Logic and faith do not go together. Many times the message of the cross, that is faith, is like foolishness to them who are perishing. That is, it's illogical. So faith many times is, it appears illogical. So don't rationalize what the Holy Ghost tells you. You understand? Before you act on it. If you are immediate in acting on it, you will get the results there and then. Hallelujah. The devil was operating with logic, thinking once I kill Jesus, that's it. I will silence him. That's logic. God was operating by faith. My son must die that many sons may come to glory. The devil felt, let his son die and let every noise cease. That's logic. God said, let my son die that the kernel of wheat might produce much more. John 14:24. Except the kernel of wheat falls into the ground and die, it abides alone. When it dies, bring it forth much fruit. The devil didn't understand that one. Faith and logic don't go together. So be immediate, be prompt with it. Whatever the Lord tells you to do. Amen. Hallelujah. Remember the Samaritan leper too. We have other examples. Being prompt is a sign of faith, and faith is what pleases God. So be prompt with it. Don't delay. Don't delay your thanksgiving. To make it practical. Finally, express it. I said, think about it, number one. Be prompt with it, number two. Practical thanksgiving. Finally, express it. Thanksgiving must be expressed. It must be demonstrated. You know what people say, can't see my insides. Can't see my stomach. Honestly, I'm grateful, but you can't see it. Yes, we don't need to see it, but thanksgiving must be expressed. Do you understand? I saw Brother Wale this morning during praise worship. His move today was different. I think it's because it was thanksgiving. The guy went on his knees like this, and he was dancing on his knees. I told my wife, I said, see Brother Wale, I didn't even plan to do it. Me too, I'm praising God now on my knees. I saw you. Hallelujah. What was the guy doing? Expressing it. Expressing it. Why do you think Michal, the daughter of Saul, got mad? Because David was expressing his gratitude. And he was jumping and leaping and swirling, you know. and rejoicing. He was excited. I just said, see the king of Israel. See this nonsense. Say me. That's why God chose me over your bye-bye. Express it. Hallelujah. Express it. I've said you can be extravagant with thanksgiving. Express it. If people have to make room for you, I said this one is serious. Let them make room for you if it is thanksgiving you are doing. Because you are the one who knows what God has done for you. Praise the Lord. Express it. So thanksgiving must be demonstrated. Look at Hannah at Shiloh. She was grateful. By the time she went back for the second Shiloh, to dedicate the boy, to present the boy to the priest, Eli. She came with thanksgiving this time. My soul rejoices in God, my maker. For he has made the barren woman to become a keeper, joyful mother of children. I rejoice and I magnify. She said, rejoice not my enemy. Again, don't make noise no more. God has visited me. Now I'm fulfilled. She was thankful to God. She expressed it. Hallelujah. It must be expressed. Look at the woman with the alabaster box. Jesus was in the house. Maybe we should read. Jesus was in the house. Luke chapter 7. We don't have time. Maybe I'll just mention a few things. Jesus entered the house. This was desert environment. And usually in desert environment, what happens? Your feet will gather dust. She entered the house of Simon the leper, who invited him to dinner. So he honored the invitation to have dinner or lunch, whatever you prefer, in the house of Simon the leper. And this woman was there. And she knelt at his feet. And she began to shed tears, using the tears to wash his feet, dusty feet. And she did not look for a towel to dry the feet. She rather used her long hair to wipe the feet of Jesus. I didn't write it though. So it's not my imagination. I don't know how many women, all things being equal, because that's important. Because sometimes all things are not equal. The pastor that was feeding his congregation snakes, all things were not equal. In fact, he's not even a pastor to start with. But the one that was asking them to eat grass. You saw the videos, right? That one can't be normal. They said when they looked for him to give him grass to eat, he ran away. Praise the Lord. But how many women would wipe the feet of their husbands with their hair? How many women will shed tears and use their tears? How many? I'm not saying there are no women like that, but I'm saying how many. We were at a wedding the other day and the preacher was preaching. And she said, when you offend each other, let the wife kneel down. I said, sweetheart, darling, what have I done? Mabinu? Something. Me and the pastor that we said, I said, they don't do that, oh. I said, when your wife wants to beg you, she said, so what are you going to eat? So kilo my dear. That's our way of saying that's our own way of saying I'm sorry. Men, am I communicating? So the thing reaching aside. I didn't know. But men, when you offend, how do you make up when you offend? Won't you say I'm sorry? Mean honestly. Oh. And you could not be no close here. But your wife will say, what are you going to eat? Hey. So how many women will shed tears to wipe your dust of it and use their hair to clean the dust of it and then bring out their precious ointment? You know, women, they are wonderful people. If you are a bachelor, God will give you a good wife. They are wonderful people. They know how to send somebody message. Your wife will plan your trip for you. Hey, JB, you are coming through Adamasiba. Stop at the Kote Edo, by the right side, you will see one woman. Help me buy this, my darling, sweetheart. That's when they remember you are sweetheart. Mama doesn't do it too often. Just once in a while. But I know that some women do it very often. They will plot your journey for you. So by the time your wife asks you to buy her a very expensive perfume and you buy it, and for goodness sake, men, buy things for your wives. Is that okay? Husbands, buy things for your wives. Men are not really responding now. Buy things for your wives. Buy things for them. Buy things for them. Buy things for them. Pastor, it's Thanksgiving Sunday. That's part of why you are thanking God that God has given you a good wife. Buy things for you. Praise God. That expensive perfume, she now does not use it on herself. Because that woman had that perfume, I'm sure that cost a year's wages for herself. It was precious to her. And maybe she had kept it for her daughter's wedding ceremony. And when my daughter's going to get married, they go take. Who will take? I don't know. But that day, a finger was placed on the perfume. It's not for you. It is for the master. And she broke the alabaster box. And she wasted her best on the feet, not on the head. If you read it in Matthew, Mark, the head. But Luke was the one that said the feet. Praise the Lord. She wasted her best at the feet of some will say times. So why must I if you put 1,000 inside, so long is God has God not been good for the whole year, 1,000 naira, and your annual income is in six figures. Your annual income is in seven figures. You now put 1,000. You don't, there are criminals in church. Grandma, you don't know. It's yourself, you know. They just put 1,000 and make it anonymous. So that on the many to physical lala, you won't know who put it there. It's between you and your God. That's no man's business. Praise the Lord. What am I saying? She expressed it. It cost her her tears. It cost her her personal honor. She wiped his feet with her hair. It cost her something very expensive, her money, her substance. It cost her that. Why? She was expressing it. Express thanksgiving. Hey, what you don't give to God, the devil will take. Ask people who don't pay tithes. They should calculate their monies that are outside. Opportunities that they have missed. You'll be amazed. Praise the Lord. So it must be demonstrated. It must be expressed. In Genesis chapter 18, three visitors came to meet Abraham in the heat of the day. He decided to entertain them. Excuse me, what did he kill? Please, what did he kill? Cow. I said, what did he kill? A fatted for how many people? That not too much. Let me ask you in vernacular, for three people, a whole cow, for three, how much will they eat? But it was because he recognized these were not ordinary men. Read the story further down. One of them was the Lord. We call that theophany. Theophany. Theo. God. Funny. Appearance. Theophany. T-H-E-O-P-H-A-N-Y. Theophany. One of them was the Lord. A theophany is an appearance of Jesus Christ in the Old Testament before he finally came in the New. Because he said, shall I hide from my friend Abraham that which I'm about to do? In that Genesis 18. After eating. It was after eating that he said, shall I hide? Abraham has honored us far. Any lonely person here? The two other people were angels. Those ones went ahead to Sodom and Gomorrah while Abraham stood yet before the Lord. The Lord was the third person. Do you understand? Express it. Someone say express it. Express it. Express it. Demonstrate it. Show it. Your emotions are involved. Your body is involved. Every part of you is involved in thanking God. Amen. I don't have time. Psalm 116 verse 12 to 14. What shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits toward me? I will take the cup. I will take action. I will take the cup of salvation. I will take the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. Action. I will pay my vows. Action. Unto the Lord now in the presence of all his people. I will call upon the Lord. I will take the cup of salvation. What shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits towards me? Action. What shall I render? I will take the cup of salvation. The cup of salvation. The cup of salvation. Part of their daily worship, I was explaining on Friday, part of their daily worship in the Old Testament was the burnt offering. They had the daily burnt offering. And with the daily burnt offering, there were meal offerings that will go with it. And that's the offering of a flour. And then there was also what we call the drink offering that will go with it. So they will pour some drinks upon the altar. Amen. Praise the Lord. Now the cup of pouring the drink for the expression of their worship and thanksgiving for daily sustenance was that which the psalmist called there the cup of salvation. Agubala. Cup of salvation. Hallelujah. It was a cup of thanksgiving. Have you come with your cup this morning? I'm asking. I said, have you come with your cup this morning? Praise the Lord. And do you know that God is after your heart? Your heart, primarily. Your substance must be involved, yes? Somebody said, Pastor, I won't be in church this morning because I don't have money for my Thanksgiving. I said, but you have a heart for your Thanksgiving. Even the Thanksgiving is something you planned for. You knew from this time last year that in a year's time, you are coming back for Thanksgiving. If your daughter will get married, if your daughter will be getting married, will you say, it took me by surprise? Or if you are the one getting married, will you say, oh, walo didi? But you know, human beings are very wise. Very wise. But your heart, essentially, is what the Lord needs. Thanksgiving. Let's bow down our heads. Make it practical. Think about it. Be prompt with it. Express it. It's three simple points. Can you receive grace to live in thanksgiving? Because thanksgiving is thanks living, actually. Lord, I receive grace to live perpetually in thanksgiving. Because thanksgiving is thanks living. Can you receive grace to see thanksgiving as a commandment, an instruction that must be obeyed, a commandment that must be executed at all times? Receive grace to be deliberate with thanksgiving. It's something you must be deliberate about. It's a decision, not an emotion. You must be deliberate about it. Receive grace to think about it always, to be prompt with it and to express it. Lord, I receive grace to think about thanksgiving always, to express it always, to be prompt with it always. Lord, I receive grace to be infectious with my thanksgiving as well. That I will be infectious with my thanksgiving. That I will be infectious with my thanksgiving. That I will be infectious with my thanksgiving. That I will be infectious with it. Lord, help me in the name of Jesus. Once again, I'm giving us an opportunity to think back. Think back to the beginning of the year and thank God. Think back. So think about it. Consider what the likely occurrences would have been and thank God. For specific situations that you can remember, please give thanks to God. Specific occurrences in 2015, please give thanks to God. 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 Give thanks to God. Bless the Lord, O my soul. And all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul. And forget not all his benefits. Who redeemed thy life from the pit? Who crowns you with love and kindness and tender mercies? Who satisfies your desires with good things? Who renews your youth like the eagles? I know it's a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to show forth your love and kindness every morning, to proclaim your faithfulness in the evening, O God. Come to give thanks. I come to give thanks. Come to praise your name, Alpha and Omega, the first, the last, the beginning, the end. My way maker, my help, my financier, my health, my surgeon, my physician, my glory, the lifter up of my head, my sustainer, my enlarger, my promoter you are, my help, my help, my hope, my hope, my crown, my refuge, my strong tower. You are my rock, you are my rock. I praise you for the month of August. I thank you for that great deliverance you wrought for us in August. Lord, I'm grateful. I thank you for your intervention in September. Lord, you intervened, you arose, you honored your word, you arose. Lord, I'm grateful. I thank you, oh God, for the way you opened up in October, for the doors you opened in October for me. I'm grateful. I thank you, oh God, for remembering me in November. Lord, I'm grateful to you. For my household, I'm grateful. Lord, for the visitation of November, I'm grateful. For that which you did for our daughter, I'm grateful. For that which you did for our son, I'm grateful. For that which you did, oh God, for our daughter as well, I'm grateful. I'm grateful. I'm grateful for your backing. You remain our backer, our backbone. I'm grateful for your backing that we enjoy continually. Your backing that we enjoy continually. Lord, I'm grateful. I'm grateful. I'm grateful for victory upon victory. Victory upon victory. I'm grateful. Lord, I'm grateful for renewing my youth like the eagles. Lord, for granting me vigor and vitality and health and strength. I'm grateful. Lord, thank you for sound health. Thank you for provision. Thank you for the guidance of your spirit. Thank you for illumination. Thank you for instruction. Thank you for discernment. Thank you for judgment. Thank you for your perspectives over issues. I'm grateful. I'm grateful. I'm grateful. Thank you for growth and grace and in your knowledge. I'm grateful. Thank you, Lord. 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 Can you just go ahead and give him thanks? Your wife delivered this year. You got a new job this year. You were promoted this year. You became a grandparent this year. You opened up a new business this year. The Lord committed something new into your hands this year. Exalt him, exalt him, exalt him. You were cleared. There was a frame up against you in your place of work. You were cleared this year. Appreciate the Lord. Appreciate the Lord. Appreciate the Lord. The Lord gave you victory over a loved one. Exalt him. You got born again this year. You got saved this year. Give him praise. Worship him. Worship him. Worship him. Worship him. Thank you, Lord. Oh, Father, we bless your name. Oh, we bless your name. We're going to sing Oba Oba. Yes, he's the King of Kings. He's the sovereign ruler.
Only you can do these things. There is no one else like you. Oh.
Give thanks. Give thanks for every student. Every parent that has a child that is a student, join them in thanksgiving. Lord, I give you thanks for my children who are students. I praise your name. Lord, I exalt you for your help, your backing over their lives, wisdom, knowledge, understanding, helping them to read, to assimilate, oh God, and to write exams and to pass and to get promoted and to get exalted in life. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. For those writing exams right now, I praise your name. I praise your name. Lord, for the results we are expected, thank you, thank you, thank you. For their good results. Their good results, excellent results. Thank you for those that got admission this year in this church into universities or institutions of their choice. Thank you for those who wrote exams and passed. Oh God, all our students, we praise your name for excellence, for distinction, for your help. We praise you, we praise you, we praise you, we praise you, we praise you. None of them lost their minds. None of them ended up in the psychiatric ward. We exalt you. You are faithful. You are faithful. Thank you, Father. We exalt you. In Jesus' name, we give thanks. And Father, it is our desire that all the days of our lives, we will give thanks to you. We will give thanks to you without condition. Without strings attached, we will give thanks to you. Again, we have come to say thank you for all that you have done. In Jesus' name, we give thanks. Amen. We're going to be praying for ourselves during the Thanksgiving. But let me pray for you generally right now. But before I pray, if you are here and you want to make peace with your God, you want it to be written in heaven that on Thanksgiving Day, 2015, Vine Branch Apata, you got saved, you made peace with your maker, and your name was entered in the book of life. All eyes shut, all heads bowed. Just raise your right hand and say, Pastor, pray for me. I want to be saved. I want a new beginning with God. I want my sins forgiven by Christ the Savior. I want to start a new walk with my maker. Up on the gallery, down here, anybody like that, you're saying, Pastor, I need you to pray for me. I want to make peace with Jesus. I want to surrender my heart to him. He will accept you. That is the beginning of your greatness. That is how your greatness begins. Anyone who comes unto him, he will in no wise cast away, his word says. He will accept you just the way you are. No, he doesn't want you good before you come to him. He wants you to be bad so that he can make you good. He came to die for bad people so that bad people can become good people. He did not come to die for good people. No, he came to the world for bad people so that bad people can become good people. He's the one that will make you good. Don't say, no, I'm not good enough. No, 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 no. You are bad enough. In your badness, you are good for him so that he can bring good out of your bad. If you're raising the hand, raise it well above your head. I want to know who I'm to pray for. I see you, young man. Who else? Who else? You're coming to the Lord today. He will accept you. Okay. Young man, just put your hands across your chest. Say, Lord Jesus, today is my day. Forgive my sins. Forgive my past. Give me a new beginning. I am all yours from today. I invite you, therefore, to be my Lord and my personal Savior for the rest of my days. In Jesus' name, amen. Come and meet me in front, young man. Come and meet me in front. I want to lay hands upon you. The rest of us can rededicate our hearts unto the Lord. You can rededicate your heart unto the Lord. Tell him he remains your Lord and your Savior. Give thanks to the Lord and bless his name.
Church, child, please stretch with your hands towards God's servant as we pray. Our Father in heaven, we thank you very much for your son and servant and your views again this morning to be a blessing. Lord, we pray, God of heaven, for the blessing of heaven upon him, upon his household, upon everything that has to do with him, in the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, we declare your word. Your word that says, the voice of merrymaking, the voice of thanksgiving, the voice of rejoicing shall not depart from the habitation of the righteous. Lord, we pray that in his house, together with his household, the voice of merrymaking and thanksgiving and rejoicing shall and will never depart in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we launch him into new frontiers of your glory and your beauty, even from this time forthwith in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. Church, praise the Lord. Please, we'll be giving our tithes and offering this morning. Please take note. It's not our thanksgiving envelope, please. Don't put your thanksgiving envelope in the tithe and offering basket. When the time for thanksgiving comes, you bring your thanksgiving envelope with you and you come and drop it at the altar. So please take note. God bless you.
Ọkami yi oba orun mu ore wa so dore what I was so tadariji talaba mayi bire yi olu wa yi olu wa yi oba ai ni peku yi olu wa yi olu wa yi oba ai ni peku. Ọkàn mi yí ọba ọrùn mú ọrẹ wá sọ̀dọ̀ rẹ̀ wọ̀tàwó sọ́tàjà ríjì tàlàbà máa yí bí rẹ̀ yí olúwa
yí olúwa yí olúwa
èyí ọba
àìnípẹ́ fún
yí olúwa
yí olúwa yí olúwa yí ọba àìnípẹ́
fún yí olúwa.
O se mi lanu ma polongo re o oba to se mi lanu ma polongo re o so se lanu
o se mi lanu ma polongo re oba to se mi lanu ma polongo re
o se mi lanu o
se mi lanu ma polongo re o to se mi lanu ma polongo re.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Shall please pray over the tithes and offering. Our Father in heaven, we thank you very much again this morning for the privilege and opportunity to bring into your house our tithes and our offering. Our desire and prayer this morning is that all that we have brought this morning shall be acceptable in your sight in the name of Jesus Christ. And so, Father, we pray, God of heaven, that continually with joy we will come with tithes and offering to offer unto you in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we believe you that in this house, no one shall lack in the name of Jesus Christ. So, Lord, open the heavens upon us afresh, we pray, in the name, and pour down resources of heaven unto us in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen.
Time to rejoice with us celebrants. If you are a celebrant in the house this morning, you celebrated your birthday, wedding, anniversary in the course of the week, we want you to please rise on your feet as we celebrate with you.
Jehovah mi gaju aye lo,
Jehovah mi ga,
Jehovah mi gaju aye lo,
Jehovah mi ga.
Jehovah mi jin,
Jehovah mi jin,
Jehovah mi jin,
Jehovah mi jin,
Jehovah mi feregede,
Jehovah mi feregede,
Jehovah mi feregede,
Jehovah mi feregede,
Jehovah too much,
Oga odi o feregede,
Jehovah too much,
Oga odi o feregede,
Jehovah too much,
Oga odi o feregede.
Jehovah too much.
Oh God, oh God,
Jehovah me God, you are alone.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Precious Heavenly Father, we sincerely want to thank you for the joy that you have, Lord God Almighty, endowed us with. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for hiding unto us. Yes. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for every one of us celebrating our wedding anniversary. Lord, we believe you in the name of Jesus that it gets better, it gets sweeter. In the name of Jesus, more love, oh God, for every of our celebrants, those that are celebrating their birthdays. Lord, we ask that we add years unto them in the name of Jesus. To enter your children into a new year of bliss, into a new year of progress, into a new year of good health in the name of Jesus Christ. That your hand will rest mightily, oh God, upon everyone that is celebrating today. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. It's time to receive our visitors. If you're worshiping with us for the first time, we call you our guests. We want to celebrate you. We want to pray with you. So please stand on your feet, take your Bibles and bags, and come forward and let the church pray for you. Our guests in the house, our visitors. You are here for the first time, please be encouraged. Get on your feet and come forward. We want to bless you. We want to pray for you.
Welcome you in the name of the Lord. Jesus is divine.
We are heaven-bound. Follow best. Practical and for real. All in flight into the near realms. Near realms of His glory.
Jesus is divine.
Amen. We have just one visitor in the house this morning. That's amazing. Amen. Please, can you put your hands together for this gentle lady? Oh, we have another person coming. God bless you. Find your way to the altar. Yes.
We welcome you in the name of the Lord. Jesus, come.
Another person, please, you can join them. Spread forth our hands towards them as we pray. Thank you, Father, for ordering their steps to this place. Thank you, Father, for specific purpose. And thank you for the agenda you have for them. Thank you, Lord, because of the encounter they have had this morning. Thank you, Father, for a new vista of hope you have released. Thank you, mighty Father, for the landmarks they will begin to record from now on. Because of the effect of your word. Father, as a church, we bless them in the name of Jesus. You are blessed at home. You are blessed when you are in the field. In the name of Jesus. We give you praise and glory, Lord. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. God bless you. Please, can you move to where those gentlemen are? They will receive you better. Please, let's encourage them. Appreciate God for their lives.
Hallelujah. Please appreciate your neighbor to your left and to your right once again. Say thank you. It's good to thank you. It's good to see your face. Good to have you in church today. Praise God forever. Hallelujah. I want to appreciate the Hemsman Fellowship and the success of the Suya night yesterday. Hemsman, well done. Amen. Well done. Please clap for them properly. Okay, that one was properly. Okay, clap for them superly. Okay, thank you. Now, clap for them hyperly.
Okay.
Royal Sisters, we want to appreciate your support for the Hempstead. Please, let's clap for the Royal Sisters Fellowship. Amen. Well, thank God. The Hempstead said the turnout yesterday overwhelmed them, you know. But we are grateful to the Lord because that is how the Lord does his things. I want to appreciate every sponsor. Every sponsor. There were so many prizes. Gifts that people got yesterday. Some got belts that they really didn't like. And I had a wife say, my husband gave me belts. It's food tonight, eh? Don't look at anybody. Amen. But we had so much fun. The Lord will bless all the sponsors. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, I'm aware that some people did not get suya. Not our guests, not our visitors, but people who worked. Amen. Counseling team members, people who are in utilities, you know, people who helped to serve the suya and the drinks. Having done all the work, they didn't get. But listen, there's an arrangement made for you. No problem. You will be duly appreciated, but the Lord will bless and reward you. Amen. Lord bless and reward you. We're grateful that nobody who was an outsider or a visitor that was left out of the service. It's only people who are our own people that were missed out somehow. Amen. Okay. Get a copy of today's CD for 200 naira only. Precious Seeds 2016 is out. Can I have a copy, please? Sister Kende, the church office, Precious Seeds, can I have a copy? Thank you. It is 300 naira only. I'm sure they have not displayed it, and I wonder why. Please, but I've been help me tell them to display it. Get a table and display it so that people can start buying. There are good gifts that you can give to friends and loved ones for Christmas and New Year. Amen. Our carol night comes up this evening. We'll start at 5 p.m. so that we can leave early. Amen. Don't forget to come along with your innocent candles. We'll have such a glorious time. God's presence will be strong in this place in Jesus' mighty name. You don't want to miss the carol service. You don't want to miss the carol service. Brother Oluwaseun, sax. Carol night is this evening. The time is 5 p.m. God bless you. Amen. Those who want to take the second dose of the hepatitis vaccine, I can do so in Mokola this afternoon, the Mokola Church. Amen. So after their service, they too will end around the same time we will end, or probably later, you know. But anyway, this afternoon, I'm told. Don't miss service on Wednesday, 5:30 to 7:30 for our miracle service, and Friday, 5:30 to 7:30 for our Bible study. School of Prayers will hold this Friday from 10 past 5 to 5:30. Amen. After the announcements, we'll go into Thanksgiving. So Thanksgiving will commence after the announcements. Please take note. Area captains, please submit your reports for the month of November. And this Saturday is the Jeans Carnival of the Stag Project. Jeans Carnival this Saturday. So much of God's presence. We'll have fun. We'll be educated. We'll be prayed for, ministered unto. Everybody must wear jeans. It is for young men between the ages of 14 and 25. I remember, as a chronic unbeliever, I will leave Ibadan for Augustine Polytechnic. For Jeans Carnival. How many people remember? How many people have gone for Jeans Carnival? Before in Egba? Jeans Carnival. We'll go. We use swimming pool side at the Augustate Hotel for Jeans Carnival. You know? But now, Jeans Carnival is holding under the canopy of grace, with Christ being the center of it. The devil is losing ground so fast. So if you know any young person, male, between the ages of 14 and 25, they should be at Jeans Carnival of the Stack Project this Saturday. The time is 3 p.m. The venues are Mokola Center. We'll be making use of a car park, not the church building, because that won't be able to contain us. Amen. I will be there as well. And this coming Sunday is our casual Sunday. We'll be casually dressed to church. Nothing like Buba and Shokoto. That's not casual. You know, nothing like Agbada or Gili. That's not casual. Wear a t-shirt. Amen. That's casual. Praise the Lord. Or just a casual shirt, you know, or a simple blouse and skirt for ladies. Amen. Casual Sunday, be casually dressed, but we'll have a rich time in God's presence. We will be affected irreversibly. Invite your unchurched friends. Invite your unsaved friends. Want to appreciate people who have redeemed their pledges. Those seeds you have sown will keep speaking over your lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Please take your quiet time very seriously. As the year is drawing to an end, let's be more intimate with the Lord. Let's be more security conscious as well. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Thank you. Alagba. That's Alagba all the way from Abuja. You can see his immaculate white. And here we are, precious, since 2016. I hope it's on display. Is it on display on the way out? Precious seeds. Brother Nii, Sister Kende, Sister Sophia in the church office, please help ensure that the precious seeds are on display before service is over today. Amen. Thank you. 300 naira per copy. I'm also told that the sticker for our 17th anniversary is out. Amen. It's 50 naira only. Buy one today. Buy two, buy three, buy four, buy five. Buy for a friend. Buy for a loved one. Amen. The sticker is out. Thank you. So, and it's so beautiful. Look at it. How many can read what is on it? Rule in red. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Honestly, we will rule. We have no choice than to rule. Amen. Part of what it means to rule is to draw a line. You must draw. There are some lines you must draw and tell the devil, you can't cross. You can't. It's part of rule. There's a revelation inside our rule. Amen. Praise the Lord. So 50 naira for the sticker. Dekina Loko, am I correct, sir? And then they have also said the anniversary stroke Christmas cards are available at a revised rate of 150 naira each. If you want them to customize for you, let them know. They will tell you the price implication. Get your copies today. Christmas is around the corner. God bless you as you comply. Christmas Day service will hold on Christmas Day, 25th December, 10 a.m. to 12 noon. And Family Sunday, last Sunday of this month, 8:30 a.m. Please come. Let's celebrate family together. New members will be received last Sunday of December. You want to join this church? You want to make this church your church? We'll call you out last Sunday of this month and pray for you. And all those who join the church this year, we'll be having a get-together for you on that Sunday as well. Of course, those who will be joining that Sunday will join us as well for the get-together. We disbursed 131,000 during the week towards doors at Elaju. You know, we have a balance of 19,000 for that and so on. We announced during the week. Our video mixer has been purchased. It cost $1,000. We're waiting for somebody coming home from Houston, Texas to bring it home for us so that we won't have to pay for courier. New members, okay, we've announced that. We can double numerically as we keep inviting people to church. So please don't forget. Be faithful with your tithes, be faithful with your offerings if you see yourself as a believer in Christ. Let's not forget our confession for the month of December. Romans 8:32. He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Listen, he will freely give us all things. So this December, all things are mine in Jesus' name. This December, all things are mine in Jesus' name. Let's not forget our creed. They asked the little girl for the Vine Branch Creed yesterday, and she did it so well. Amen. I hope we know the creed by heart now. So Vine Branch is to be a dream church where every member loves God passionately, serves God, family, and society passionately, and lives passionately, maximizing our potentials. So help us, God. I want to say happy wedding anniversary to our ministers, the Ojos and the Oshubus. Amen. Today is their wedding anniversary. Today, how many years? 18. Praise God. For both of you, it's 18. Aha. No wonder yesterday, Pastor Ojo said that they were joined at the first service and that the Oshubus were joined at the second service. But Miss Oshubu said, she said, what time did the first service end? Amen. So we don't know by how many minutes, one or hours, you know, the seniority would be reckoned. But we want to thank God for keeping your homes for the past 18 years. And they have informed me that they are providing drinks for church free of charge. So take a drink after Thanksgiving before you go home, courtesy of the two families today. Praise the Lord. Thank you for clapping. God bless you. Amen. Now, please, the order of Thanksgiving will be announced shortly. I did my own sleep. What's happening? It used to be very, very... Amen. I hope she's not feeling sleepy. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I have a few announcements to make for Thanksgiving. You may have to come out several times. You may be called out several times for one reason or the other, you know, for Thanksgiving. But you only have one envelope. So drop it just once. Once you drop it once, that's it. Regardless of the number of times, you will come out. Please take note of that. Now, every group that will be coming out from here. Look at my handle. We'll be coming out from here. And we'll be leaving the altar like that. So that the next group will just come from that same place. Amen. So we won't be colliding with one another. Is that okay by us? Please take note of that. So we'll be coming from your right and we'll be leaving from your left. Amen. Now we have said, please write your prayer request inside your Thanksgiving offering envelopes and make them just three. Amen. Three prayer points that you want us to pray for you about. And don't forget to write your names on your envelopes. That's important so that we can pray for you by name. But once there's no name on the envelope, you can't be sure that we'll just put it quietly aside. So the first group to come forward for Thanksgiving will be the Children's Church. They'll be followed by the Vine Boards, followed by the Properties, followed by the Royal Sisters, followed by the Henchmen, followed by the visitors to church today. I can see just three of you or so. Amen. You may remain seated there, but Agbenga, let them remain seated there. Followed by all workers in church. Don't say workers. Members of activity teams. People who are serving faithfully in different groups in church. And then lastly, the ministers will come up. Amen. So, but before we start praying for the groups, I want to ask who God has been merciful to this year. Who is it that God has shown mercy this year? Who is it that God has shown kindness unto this year? Who is it that God has been gracious unto this year? Has God been good to you? You don't sound like it. Has God been good to you? There's a song that is like a question. Actually, it's a question. It says, "Eni Oluwa she Loreda." That song says, "Who is it that the Lord has been good to?" But Ashil, you will help me sing that song. I want to see the people that God has shilori before we start calling out the groups. Amen. Eni Oluwa she Loreda.
Eni Oluwa she Lore. Kona wa soke, o se mi o, o se mi o, mo dupe lowo Jesu Olubala, aleluya mo wa dupe, eniyan lo kole alaja beba, lo jade laye, mo dupe lowo Jesu Olubala, eni Oluwa se Lore, kona wa soke. O se mi o, o se mi o, Olupe lowo Jesu Olupe. Eni Oluwa se Lore da, ona wa soke. O se mi o, o se mi o, Olupe lowo Jesu Olupe. Hallelujah. Oh,
impact your life this year, come to the altar. Something new entered your life this year, or your marriage, or your family, or your business, or your career. Come to the altar. Something new.
Thanksgiving now.
Bless you.
We lift our hands in the sanctuary. We lift our hands to give you the glory. We lift our hands to give you the praise. And we will praise you for the rest of our days. Yes, we will praise you for the rest of our days. We lift our hands.
We lift our hands.
You are my key.
Your life is me to
see. I will praise you all my days. Perfect in all your ways.
You,
Jesus, you are my Lord.
I will obey your word.
I want to see your kingdom come. Not my will, but yours be done. Glory, glory to the Lamb. Glory, glory to the Lamb. You took me into the Lamb. We will conquer in your name.
Everybody sing, hail, hail, Lion of Judah.
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 How wonderful you are.
How wonderful you are.
Praise the Lord. Unless the Lord builds the house, they labor in vain who build it. Unless the Lord guides the city, the watchman stays awake in vain. It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows, for so he gives his beloved sleep. Behold, children are a heritage from the Lord. The fruit of the womb is a reward. Like arrows in the hand of a warrior, so are the children of one's youth. Happy is the man who has his quiver full of them. They shall not be ashamed, but shall speak with their enemies in the gates. Amen.
Stretch our hands towards our children, please, and bless them. Father, your word says the seed of a righteous are mighty upon the earth. Your word says, as arrows are in the hands of a mighty man, so are the children of a youth. Your word says, happy is the man that hath the quiver full of them. He will not be ashamed. They will speak with the enemies in the gate. Lord, these are your heritage, and these are your rewards. Let your blessing rest upon their lives. We are grateful for giving them unto us as custodians, as parents, as stewards. And Lord, it's our prayer that these children will turn out to be who you have ordained for them to be here on earth in the name of Jesus Christ. Every single one of you and everyone represented by you will run in your own lanes in life in the name of Jesus. You will operate from your own tracks. You will fulfill divine mandate in the name of Jesus Christ. Over you, we will always be grateful. Concerning you, we will always celebrate the goodness of the Lord. I ask for the spirit of excellence and distinction from on high to rest upon you children in the name of Jesus Christ. From your earliest accountable ages, you will know the Lord Christ and you will serve him all your days. You will lead many to righteousness. And you will shine like the stars in the brightness of the heavens. In life, always you'll be in front and never behind. Always you'll be on top and never beneath. In the name of Jesus. So the blessing is upon you to cause you to excel in life. So I bless you with the blessings of heaven, the blessings of the earth. Bless you with the blessings of the blood of the Lamb of God, with the blessings of favor and wisdom and strength and health and vigor and vitality and skills and talents that will announce you to your world. You will showcase excellence to this world in the name of Jesus. Each of you will have renown. None of you will serve the other in the name of Jesus. Again, you are blessed, for you carry the blessing in the name of Jesus Christ. And your generation will proclaim this gospel, and nations will hear you. Again, you are blessed, and no man can turn it around. Thank you, everlasting Father. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. So children, you are living like this. You are living like this. Thank you. God bless you. Thank you very much. Buds are next. The vine buds are next. So if you are a vine bud, you can just stay while others are laid out. Amen. Thank you.
Jesus, love, how great I am. The one that is more than enough. My everything, my all in all, I will live to praise your name. Jesus, love I, how great I am. Your honor is my everything, my all in all, I will live to praise your name. Oh, why, yeah, how about me, break up? Oh, why, yeah. Just you, Lord. great I am, the one that is mother in all, my everything, my heart in all. I will live to praise your name. Boom, boom, oh, why, yeah, and what about me, baby? Oh, why, yeah. Lord, you reign forever.
Amen, amen.
We worship amen. You.
Amen. Psalm 128. Blessed is everyone that fear the Lord, that walk in his ways. For thou shalt eat the labor of thy hands. Happy shalt thou be, and shall be well with thee. Thy wife shall be as a fruitful vine by the side of thy house. Thy children like holy plants round about thy table. Behold, that thou shalt the man that bless,
hallelujah,
that fear the Lord. Be blessed that fear the Lord. The Lord shall bless thee out of Zion, and thou shalt see the good of Jerusalem all the days of thy life. Yea, thou shalt see thy children's children, and peace upon Israel.
Toward the divine box, even as you pray for them. Heavenly Father, we appreciate you on behalf of your children in divine box fellowship. We want to thank you for your love and mercy in the year 2015 over them. We want to appreciate you for endowment in the year 2015 concerning these ones. We want to thank you for your mind, your good thoughts towards them. We thank you because you have been faithful. In their individual lives, you have been faithful. We bless your name, righteous Father. We thank you for you have been a good God. We bless your name. You commit them into your able hand. Thank you because you've made them, every one of them, olive plants, so they shall remain in Jesus' name. Thank you because your good thoughts towards them now and in the future we come to full materialization in Jesus' name. Thank you, righteous Father, because these ones, the Bible says the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. They will fear you. They will work for you. They will love you. They will serve you. I pray for you, each and every one of you, boys and girls, you will not serve your enemies. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the grace to always seek God, the grace to always love him, the grace to always want to do his biddings, receive now in the name of Jesus Christ. All the days of your life, everything that will bring forth celebration in your lives, so shall we be. We have in Jesus' name. Every day of your life, the Lord God will grant you excellence in all that you do, in all your undertakings, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Bible said, our children are taught of the Lord, and great shall be the peace of our children. I decree upon your life, all the days of your life, you shall be taught of the Lord. Great shall be your peace. Great shall be the peace of your parents over you, in the mighty name of Jesus. We want to appreciate God on behalf of the instructors. We receive wisdom, knowledge, understanding to nurture this one, to grow and become what the Lord wants them to be. We receive for each and every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for you. You will grow in stature, children. You will grow in understanding. You will be loved by God continually. You will not serve your enemy. You will grow in stature. You will grow in the fear of the Lord. All things that pertains to life and godliness, you will walk all to all the days of your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Concerning your lot has secured. Your lot has secured in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name. The blood will always avail for you. The blood will always speak for you. The blood will always answer for you. Every day of your life, we will not sorrow over you. In year 2016, the Lord will take you high. The Lord will take you high. Grants will be broken on behalf of you. Doors will be opened for you. as many of you that seek admission in that year, the Lord will grant you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You will know more than your teachers in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Whatever it is that you desire or your parents desire for you to take you high, the Lord will make it possible in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. All things will work together for your good, both now and in the future, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we appreciate you. We bless you because you have heard us. To you be glory and honor forever. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
And praise the Lord. Vineboards, let's clap for them, please. Amen. Thank you very much. Most of them were not saying amen. This thing is too loud. Shut them down. Amen. Praise the Lord. It's going to be the turn of the Propertons in a short while. But if you got married this year, you got married this year, I want you to come here. You got married this year. You went to the altar this year. Come and stand in front of the altar. Praise the Lord. You got married this year. You got married this year. I can see the Adelis. I can see the Makides. I can see the Akimbis. I can see the Ogedegbis. Amen. You got married this year. Who else? I think there should be one more person I'm waiting for. Okay. Now, if you had a baby this year, especially your firstborn this year, come and join them. Your first baby this year. My grandma is joining them because her first grandchild came this year. Amen. Had a baby this year, especially your first. Amen. But Dani is coming. Praise the Lord. Grandmas are coming. Hallelujah. Grandmas are coming. Daddies are coming. Daddy OKDG. Daddy Adekuke. Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay. Mommy Olowo Kere. Mommy Adesoye. You're welcome. That's right. That's Mommy Adishoka also coming with the prince. Daddy Oshinawa coming. Hallelujah. These are the people populating Nigeria. Careful, Mommy. Careful. Careful. God bless you. God bless you. Mommy Oshinawa. Amen. We give thanks to the Lord. I want a set of people to join them for Thanksgiving. If you trust God that in the year 2016 you will go to the altar to say, I do, come and join them. If in the year 2016 you trust God to be able to present your own baby on the altar to say, that's my baby, come and join them for Thanksgiving. You are joining them for Thanksgiving. You are thanking God in faith. It's a language of faith. It's a language of faith. And what the Lord will honor is your faith. What the Lord will honor is your faith. What the Lord will honor is your faith. You too will be called joyful mothers of children. You too will be called couples, Mr. and Mrs. Lagbaja, whatever. Amen. You too will be able to bandy in your hand your wedding band. And do this when you are describing somewhere to people. Amen. So that they can see. So that they can see. Hallelujah. Amen. I said amen. Oh, they're still coming. They're still coming. They are still coming. They are still coming. Praise God forevermore. Please make room for them. This is faith in action. Faith in action. Through Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving is the language of faith. But I shall let them now give thanks to the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah.
I want to see you. What shall we say unto the Lord? All we have to say is thank you, Lord. What shall we say unto the Lord? All we have to say is thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All we have to say is thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Amen. Let us pray. Let us pray. Lord, we are grateful. For those that went to the altar this year, we are grateful. For those that you blessed with children this year, we are grateful. Thank you, because when you bless, it is forever. No man can add to it. No man can take from it. The word says you do it that men may fear before you. Again, we are grateful. And thank you for those who have joined them to draw strength from them, saying they believe you that in 2016, they also will go to the altar to say, I do. Saying they believe you in 2016, that they also will conceive and bring forth children to the glory of your name. Lord, honor their faith, and be it unto you according to your faith in the year 2016. You will not miss your seasons. You will not miss your seasons. I command every shut womb therefore to open. I command every shut door Ephata, in the name of Jesus. Receive your joy and return with your thanksgiving. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. Thank you very much. You go like this, please. You go like this. You go this way, because a group is getting ready to come from that place. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Where Elobami say,
where Elobami say,
where Elobami say,
where Elobami say,
on tomorrow. Everybody sing,
to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Let's pray for them. Church, let's pray for them. Father, to whom all praise belong, we appreciate you for these ones. Thank you for being their shield. Thank you for being their buckler. Thank you for being their keeper. Thank you for being so good unto them. We appreciate you. Daddy, take all glory in the mighty name of Jesus. All year round, oh God, you have been keeping, preserving and protecting them. You did not allow the enemy to steal, to kill and to destroy concerning these ones, oh God. Father, we are seeing your grace upon their lives. We are seeing your glory and deity over their lives. We appreciate you, Lord, for the sin, for the unseen concerning these ones, oh God. You are the one nurturing them, taking care of them, oh God. Therefore, successes in their exams, oh God. Moving them from one level of glory to another level of glory. It is your doing, oh God, and it is so marvelous in our sight, oh God. We appreciate you, oh Lord, because we have not had any cause, oh God, to sorrow, to mourn, or to cry over these ones, oh God. Father, we bless you. We say, Daddy, take all glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Everlasting Father, you are the unchanging changer. Lord, you said whatever is committed into your hands, you are able to keep the day of Christ. Oh God, we are once again committing these ones into your hands, oh God, that you yet keep them in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord shall yet keep you in the mighty name of Jesus. He will preserve you in the mighty name of Jesus. Over you, we will not sorrow. Over you, we will not mourn. Over you, we will not cry. As your name implies, properties, you shall be proper in every area of life in the mighty name of Jesus. In wisdom, in knowledge, in understanding, you shall be proper indeed in the mighty name of Jesus. Hearing, you are declared once again as light in the midst of God's people. Begin to shine in the name of Jesus. Begin to shine in the name of Jesus. Your generation shall call you blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Generation yet unborn shall call you blessed in the name of Jesus. And you are declared even as salt. In the name of Jesus, you will not lose savor. You shall be people of influence in the name of Jesus. Your hands shall bear rule in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare to you in the name of Jesus Christ that you shall be the head and not the tail in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will uphold you always in the name of Jesus. You will serve the Lord. You will serve the Lord. You will know the Lord. You will walk with the Lord. I prophesy unto your lives in the name of Jesus Christ.